Hi, I'm Cyaneink, and this is Turner Acrylic Gouache review. In my latest haul, I ordered these Turner Acrylic Gouache sets. I have the smart set and japanesque colors. Then I have some loose type dupes and some of these mediums and varnishes and primers that they have. But first I will focus these for these paints. These are acrylic gouache, so when they dry they are like gouache, they have a matte finish, but when they are used they behave more like acrylics because they aren't water soluble anymore when they are dried out. But I noticed this took a little bit more time to dry than acrylics, so you have a little bit more blending time. And also if the blending time is the issue, you can use this Turner Acrylic Gouache Retarder. That's really expands the time that they are workable. And these smaller tubes are 5 milliliters, and the colors are really pigmented, like it goes really long way. I have painted 2 small paintings with these, and I can't like these tubes look like they are completely full still. This small set came with 4 brushes. 2 of them are round ones, which are these Japanese style round ones, I would say. And then there are 2 flat ones. These are regular synthetics brushes, and I find these works especially well with these. Because it's a little bit more thicker than normal like watercolors, I really recommend using like basic synthetic tack long that is really snappy. And the colors are here. As you can see, they are pretty much opaque, but some of the colors aren't like this permanent scarlet or permanent lemon or those permanent yellow deep. But black is really opaque, also is the white and all the other colors. I find these are really great quality, and they are really easy to get these like smooth colors. I like how these perform on the paper. But I tried them on different surfaces, because these are like it's really confusing that they are like acrylic gouaches. These behave like more like matte acrylics, not like gouaches. You can mix these with water, and there was somewhere there was like instructions to mix 1 part of paint and 2 parts of paint and 1 part of water. So they are mixed with water, but they dry waterproof. And that means that when you put this on the palette, you have to use the whole paint because you can't like save it later. But maybe you can if you use something like airtight palette or something like those things. And these ones has these loose type tubes are 20 milliliters and these are 5 milliliters. So if you buy the loose type tubes, they are a little bit bigger. But I think the little bit of this paint goes really long way. These are really pigmented, and especially if you are using these in like watercolor type things, you only need like a little dab of paint and it will go really long way. Also what the Turner makes, here are the japanesque color set. And I didn't first know, but these japanesque colors are different. They try different finish. Where these normal colors have this basic gouache finish that is, I would call like matte satin finish. Then this japanesque colors has more quarter texture. This feels like there would be like almost like sand on the surface. They are really like rough, so it's really different finish. But it didn't rub off or anything, but it feels a little rough. So if you want smooth paintings, these japanesque colors aren't great for that. But these japanesque colors have really nice shades. They have all these muted tones. And Turner is actually Japanese company, and all of these tubes have text in Japan and in English. Also one thing that I really like to point out, what I like these paints, they have the pigment information on the tube. You can see here that like this permanent green middle is made of pigment blue 15 and pigment yellow 3. So you have the pigment information. Not all the gouache makers have these. Also, this has the lightfast information, which is really, really important. It's back of the tube and they use that the star ratings. And in this, like, smart set, I found there is only one color that has no stars. And it's that violet one, and violet colors tend to be use pigment that aren't lightfast. Here it says fluorescent, and then it says pigment violet 33. So, if you look at that pigment, I think that pigment it is the part that will be left when the fluorescent is faded. So it's really easy to like check if the paints really like actually disappears completely after they are faded. But I have noticed that not all the pigments work that way. Some of them like turn darker, and I have found that violets especially are prone to those. But I like how they really like stand, how the lightfastness goes. But most of these have great lightfastness, like this blue one has two star ratings. And most of them have three. So that was the set that came with the... And also the with this smart set you get the palette cleaner, which was really effective. I was really like surprised. Also this lid here works as palette. And you get two large tubes of white, because with gouache it would be like better to turn the paint like tone it down with the white, not with water, because when it gets too runny it like doesn't adhere properly on the paper. And now I would like to show you some of paintings that I did with this. And because this works like acrylics, this can be used non-porous surface or porous surface. I have no issues using both. This is made on normal canvases that was like primed for acrylics, or I think I used like universal gesso on this, and it works really fine. But also I would like to have like finer surface, but this was quite coarse, but it was like my test painting. So it really adhered properly and doesn't like pool or puddle like watercolors do. So this was really well on canvases. And here I use these paints on paper. I use, as you can see, neon colors that I ordered, loose tubes, which have no like lightfast resin, and they aren't lightfastness. They aren't lightfast, but it's sometimes nice to have some neon colors. And then I use the japanesque color on hair, and I can really feel that because the hair feels really, really like colors, almost like the sandpaper. And that's quite well, that's really good to know if you want your paintings be like silky smooth, then the japanesque colors are for that thing. I have my paper that I use when I do like swatches or do some test paintings, so it's perfect for that. I will demonstrate one of these larger tubes that have like and also Turner makes different like lines of paint. They have the pastel ones, then they have pearlescent ones, these neon ones. They also have some iridescent colors and those kind of things. But I will show you with this permanent green light. And you can get like good idea. Oh, a little bit right here. A little depth there. And it should cover quite a large area. I'll use a flat brush here. And I noticed that these colors need like plenty of water to make them enough runny, because they are quite like thick. But here you can see that these are like the little paint goes a really long way. You can cover like large array with this. Also I like how this is really easy to like achieve that flat color like with regular gouache is. So that was how much you can use with like with one little bit tap you can get like this huge green pot. But this like not dry immediately, so when they are still drying you can like smooth them out or like do gradients and blend them out, which works really nicely. But when these are completely dry, you can go over and they aren't look like mixing. This isn't dry yet. Also, I like to show you some of these special colors. Here is acrylic, the pearlescent color, and this is also green. And I use even smaller color, even smaller amount of paint. And I notice with this, it don't need that much water. And also, but when you add water to this, it's really important to mix this well. As you can see, this is like pearlescent colors have this little shimmery. And this this pearlescent color wasn't opaque, but you can use. But if you want to use it, you can use it like top of the other greens to make them pearlescent. Or if you mix it white, I will be sure that it will be turn like opaque. And here is the pastel lime. Also here is also say what pigment they used. I bring a little water and there's some pearlescent on the bottom, but that shouldn't be an issue. And here is nice pastel lime color. And this is almost dry now, so as you can see, there's really easy to mix because this took like I noticed that when they seems dry on hand, but when they are, but they like don't dry immediately like fully. So when you go over, you can do a little bit mixing, but it really takes effort and it's not like it would be happened like accidentally. And this layers really well because of that, because you don't are lifting the layers under like here. So that was my short demonstration, and also I like to talk a little bit about these primers and varnishes that I got. I got the retarder one, which is like slows drying time, and it's really slows. Then there's said that it's if you use too much of it, the surface may be tacky. But Turner makes really great these labels. They are like really good instructions how to use these, which I really like. And also they give a little instruction booklet with this set, but sadly it was in Japanese, so I couldn't read that. And this is the varnish. It's look opaque in bottle, but it dries on clear gloss. And I think that I take gloss varnish because this dry matte, and matte is really easy to photograph or like scan, but gloss I think it looks better on finished pieces, so I wanted to gloss varnish. And other thing I got was wood primer. This is specially made for these paints, and it can be used on wood, so you can paint on it. And this has like really fancy bottles. And here is also the instructions how to use these. I haven't yet used these, but I think this will be really handy because I really want to paint on wood. Wood is really like inexpensive here and easier to get than canvases. So the final things about this paint that I have, I really like these. I like to paint with these, but they really like fill the gap between gouache and acrylics. These behave like acrylics, but they also behave like gouache. And I think this has like almost, I want to say like best of the both things. Only downside is that they aren't like reconstructed water when they are palette, but that's really understandable if they aren't that's really understandable because they are acrylic based. But I still like to use these very much. And one thing that I really like to mention is these are really affordable. This set I got, I think this was like something 26 pounds, which is like 30 euros or something. And this set is, this Japanese set is currently on sale, and this was like 11 pounds when I got this, so this is like really cheap. I got all of these from Jackson's Art. I will link this below if you wanna try these out. I really like how this behaves, and I think I will get like more of these loose tubes because this works really well. And I think these have like are really nice paints if you want to take photographs of your work and make prints out of them, because these dry matte. Unlike with acrylics, the gloss is always on the way on photographs. So, that was what I have. Oh, and last thing, if you really wonder, are those neon colors neon? I would say yes, they are. They are really neon. They aren't fully opaque, but they work well if you like use white under and then put this over. It really shines. Also, here is the pearlescent color. This works really well. So, that was my think about Turner Acrylic Gouache. If you have anything to ask about these paints, please ask me in comments below. And also, if you have tried these acrylic gouaches, leave the comments below. I really like to know what others think about these. So, thanks for watching and see you in my next video. Bye! And little bonus clip for end. I just used this palette cleaner thing. And here is the dried paint in this corner. And I take the rag, and when I rub this, it's like magically like disappears the whole paint in it. And these are acrylic paste, so these really stick on the plastic surface. It stains a little, but it's clean.